Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So today in this session we are going to start the new lesson from the state board standard 6, and the name of the lesson is what? Diversity in living things and their classification. Okay, so this is the last lesson from the schedule 6. So let's start to see what we are going to see in this diversity in the living things and their classification. So before going to start the lesson, I will tell you what is mean by diversity. So diversity means what? Variety. So there are the lot of variety, or there is a huge variety of the plants and also the animals that are present on the earth. And as we know, the earth is a wonderful planet. On that there is, and on the earth only there is what? Life exists. Okay, so if we'll go on the different places, then we can find out the different plants and different types of the animals. Okay, but you have ever think how these plants and animals survive climatic condition? Because plants and animals, or we can say that what the living things, are having the ability to adjust along with the surrounding, and because of that adjustment they can survive very easily in that particular environment. Okay, so in this state or on this planet there are the different plants and animals, and that plants and animals also has done the adaptation among themselves, and that is the reason they can live easily in that particular climatic condition. So in this lesson we are going to see deeply about the diversity in the living things, like that we will discuss about the diversity in the plants and the animals, and also we'll discuss about how the plants and animals are get classified, on which ways or which are the different types of the classification of plants and animals. So let's discuss about that. First we will discuss that diversity in the plants, or we'll see the variety in plants. Okay, variety in plants. So variety in the plants, it means what? Just now we have said that, or just now we have discussed about that there are the lot of, or there are the number of plants which are present on the earth. So there are the some huge trees, there are the small trees, there are the certain grasses are there, some plants are living, or some plants are growing under the water, some plants are floating on the water. Also we can say that there are the huge canopy of the plant. Now canopy means what? They are making the roof like structure. So like that, so many plants are there, and each and every plant is different from each other. Okay, if there are the number of the plant, but still there is a lot of variety in the same category of the plant. Okay, so see, I will explain you with the help of an example. If we take the example of the rose, so the rose is a one type of a plant, but that rose is having so many different variety. Okay, rose is having so many different variety. We can see the red rose, we can see the yellow rose, we can see the pink rose, and also we can see the white rose, and etc. etc. Like that we can say that there is a lot of varieties present in the rose also. Again one will again we will take the one more example. We can go through the hibiscus. Okay, hibiscus is also having the lot of variety. We can see the hibiscus flower in the red, white, pink, yellow, orange, and etc. Okay, if we'll go through our favorite fruit, that is what? Mango. Yes, if we'll go through the mango, then there is also variety in the mango, in the shape and the size is also different, and very important, the taste and the flavor of the flavor is also different in different types of the mangoes. Also we can say that rice is there, wheat is there. In the rice also there is a lot of variety. We can say that basmati rice is there, Indrayani rice is there, and etc. So like there's so many varieties present in the same types of the plants also. Okay, so this is what the variety in plants. So what we have discussed now, then there is a variety of the plants are there in the different regions the plants are living, even in the mountains region, even in the snowfall region, or we can say that very cold climatic condition is present in that region also the plants are growing, and also the plants are growing in the deserts two, okay? And each in every plant there is a so much variety, okay? Now we'll discuss that how these plants are exactly classified. First, we will see the classification of the plants on the basis of the which type of the food they are having. So first, we will see that autotrophic plants. Now, what is mean by autotrophic plants? So the plants which are making their own food with the help of the photosynthesis process, that plants are called as what? Autotrophic. Auto means what? Self. And trophic means what? Nutrition. They are consuming or they are having their nutrition by their own, that plants are called as what? Autotrophic plants. Mostly we can say that the green plants are there, that all the green plants are comes under this autotrophic nutrition, okay? Next one, we will see that there are the certain plants which are heterotrophic, or we can say that what? Parasitic. Now heterotrophic means what? Hetero means what? Other. And trophic means what? Nutrition. Hetero means what? Those who are depends for their food on other, okay? It means what? They are depends on other for their nutrition, for their food. So that category of the plants are called as what? Heterotrophic plants or parasitic plant. Parasitic means what? Those who are depends on other for the food, okay? For here we can take the example is what? Daughter plant. Daughter plant is what? Parasitic plants or what? Heterotrophic plant. So I hope you have get these two words. What is meant by autotrophic? The plants, those who are making their own food, that plants are called as what? Autotrophic plants. The plants which are depends on other for their food, that plants are called as heterotrophic or parasitic plant. And also one more is there, that for that also plants we can say as what? Heterotrophic. And also it is called as what? Insectivorous. Now what is mean by the insectivorous plant? There are the certain plants like that we can say that pitcher plant is there, drosera is there. All these are the plants which consumes the insect to fulfill their nutrition. And that is the reason that plants are called as what? Insectivorous plants, okay? So here for these insectivorous plants also we can call as what? Heterotrophic plant. Why? Because for their food they depends on other, they are not making their own food. So it means what? They are also what? Heterotrophic plants, okay? So the insectivorous is also the one type of heterotrophic plants only, but they are consuming the insect, so we can call them also what? Insectivorous plants, okay? So under feeding habits, the plants are having these three types of the classification, that are autotrophic, heterotrophic and insectivorous plant. Now the next point is that structure of plant, and that structure of plant we have already discussed in our first schedule. So we will not discuss now here and we'll move for the next point. That is, we will discuss about the classification of the plants on the basis of their size and observation, and also we can say that what? Classification on the of the plants on the basis of their nature of stem, root and the branches, okay? So let's discuss this classification of the plant. So now let's discuss the next classification of the plant on the basis of stem, okay? So the according to the size and height of the stem, plants can be classified into three groups, okay? So according to the height and according to the size of what stem, the plants can be classified into three categories, that are trees, shrubs and herbs, okay? So let's discuss each category deeply. First we will go through the trees. So this tree, if we'll say the trees, then we can think, or first thing come in our mind, that is what? Very big or the huge tree. Yes, and it is correct, okay? Why? Because the tree is a very huge as compared to the shrubs and the herbs, okay? So this tree is having very hard, thick and strong brown color stem, and it is very tall also, okay? And the branches of the trees are
above from the ground, okay, and the branches of the trees are above from the ground. See here, I can show you. Suppose this is the tree, then these branches are from above the ground, okay, means there is a so much difference, there is a so much height among the ground and the branches of the trees, okay. So the branches of the plants are on the upper part and above the ground, means there is a so much distance between the branches and the ground, okay. And these trees can survive or can live for the long period of the time or for the long duration, and that's why they are called as what? Perennial. What is meant by the perennial? That we are going to see in our next point. So here what you have to keep in your mind, that is, trees are very tall, they are having very strong, hard, very thick brown color stem. The branches are on the upper side and from above the ground, and they are very tall, okay, and they can survive, these trees can survive for the long period of a time. So this is the first category in the size and the height, on the basis of the size and the height classification. Now we will go through the shrubs, okay. Now we will go through the shrubs. So the next category we will discuss, that is what? Shrubs. So the shrubs are having the medium size, height, and the very important, the shrubs are having the stems like brown but not thick, like not very thick and hard like trees, okay. So the shrubs are having the brown color stem, but it is not that much strong and that is not thick and hard, okay. Next one, the branches of the shrubs grows from the ground, okay, or we can say that the branches of the shrubs can grow from the ground, okay. You can see in the picture also how the shrubs it is, okay. So the branches in the picture or the in the image, we can easily see that what? The branches are growing from near the ground, or which is very near to the ground. So like a trees, these shrubs can also survive for the long period of the time, but if we'll do the comparison among the trees and the shrubs, then the trees can survive for the longer period of the time than the shrubs, or we can say that the shrubs can live for the longer period of the time but not like a trees. So the shrubs can live for the long many years but less than the lifespan of the trees. Now we'll move for the next one, that is herbs, okay. So the next category of the plant, that is what? Herbs, right? And if we'll talk about the stem, then the stem of the herbs are short, green and very thin, okay. So the herbs are having short height, also they are having the green color stem, the stem is the thin and soft, okay. Or we can say, next one point we will discuss about the herbs is that the herbs may not have the branches and they can survive for the short period of the time, or their lifespan is short. We can say that the herbs can survive only for the one or two seasons, okay. So these are the three categories on the basis of size and height of the stem, that are trees, shrubs and herbs. We will take the example, for if we'll talk about the example, then trees, we can say that peepal tree is there, mango, cashew nut, chiku, jackfruit, so many trees are there. If we'll talk about the shrubs, then we'll say the rose is there, hibiscus is there, lemon is there, oranges is there, all these are comes under what? Shrubs. And if we'll talk about examples of herbs, then we can say that tomato, mustard and sunflower, okay. So this is the classification of the plants on the basis of what? Size and height of stem. Now we will discuss the next classification of the plant according to the period of life cycle. Plants are classified as, means what? According to the period of life cycle, okay, means how much time it grows or how much time it survives, it means what? According to the lifespan of the plants are again get divided into three categories, that are annuals, biennials and perennials, okay. So from the name only you can understood that annuals means what? The plants, okay, the any plants which completes their biological life cycle within 1 year, then that plants are called as what? Annual plants. Now biological life cycle means what? Fruiting and the flowering, okay. So if the plants is completing their life cycle, means what? If the plants are fruiting and flowering within the 1 year, then that plant is called as what? Annual plants. Next one category is there, if the plants biennial, okay. So the plants is completing their biological cycle within 2 years, then that plants is called as what? Biennials. Okay, so if we talk about the biennial plants, in the biennial plants, in the first year the plants are having only the vegetative growth, and in the next year the plants are having the flowering and fruiting, and then it get die. Okay, so within the 2 years they are completing their life cycle, that's why they are called as what? Biennials. Bi means what? 2. Within the 2 years they are completing their life cycle. And the next one we will discuss, that is what? Perennial. Now perennial means what? The plants are surviving for the many years. Okay, we cannot count also. Like that, plants are called as what? Perennial plants. Okay, so the plants can survive maximum years for the long period of the, or for the long duration, then that plants are called as what? Perennial plants. Mostly the trees are coming into the perennials. This is the classification of the plants on the basis of their life cycle, that are annuals, biennials and perennials. Okay, if we'll talk about the certain examples of the annual plants, then we can say that mostly the cereal crops comes under what? These annual plants. And if we'll talk about the examples of the biennial plants, then we can say that carrot is there, beetroot is there, all these plants are called as what? Biennial plants. While perennial plants, we can say the gulmohar is there, mango is there, cashew nut is there. Also we can say that what? Hibiscus is also there. All these are the example of these perennial plants. Okay, so this is all about annuals, biennials and perennials plant. So we can say that there are the certain plants which stems are so much thin and so much weak. For example, or vines. Okay, vines are again having two types. Some are the vines which climbs on the support. Okay, or they are climbing on the supports, they are called as what? Climbers. While there are the certain plants, those who crawl on the ground. Okay, and that types of the vines are called as what? Creepers. Okay, so these are also the two types of the vines. Now we'll move for the next type of the classification of the plant. So there are the so many plants are there, but among that there are the certain plants which bears the flowers. Okay, or the plants which bears the flowers, that plants are called as what? Flowering plants. And also it is having one scientific name, then it is called as what? Angiosperm. Okay, then it is called as what? Angiosperm. So what is mean by the angiosperm? The flowering plants are called as angiosperm. While there are the certain plants, those who doesn't bear the flowers, and that flower plants are called as what? Non-flowering plants. And the one biological word we are using for that, that is what? Gymnosperm. That plants are called as what? Gymnosperm. So angiosperms and gymnosperm. What is mean by angiosperm? Flowering plants are called as angiosperm. While gymnosperm, what is mean by gymnosperm? Non-flowering plants are called as what? Gymnosperm. Okay, this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the variety in the plant, and also we have discussed about the classification of the plant on the different basis. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We'll meet in the next video for the discussion of the next point. And for today, thank you.